It's a hip hop unboxing. Hip hop unboxing. Here we go.
All right. So coming in here from.
Oak Ridge, Tennessee.
Is that where the Oak Ridge boys are from?
Could be.
Right? Who knows? I'm definitely asking the wrong crowd.
Yeah, I was like, could be.
Okay. Okay. While I'm opening this, let me just tell you, the first time I ever heard of MF Doom is... No, that's fine. Is in the Source magazine, okay? And this is me just yesterday... Standing with Dave Mays and our my good friend and broadcaster, Peace Stew. Everyone knows Peace Stew. And Dave Mays came over here to talk about some big business moves. And I just want to send a shout out to him for changing my life forever, because I used to read that magazine literally like the Bible.
I had a subscription for like 4 years straight.
Okay, here we go. Unboxing. Oh. Bam! Look at that. Get in on that. Yeah, look at that. Bam! Mad Villain. Here we go. Oh my god, you guys. Holy cow. Look at that. Wow. The Mad Villain box set. Wow. Oh my god,
like Christmas all over again.
Let's see, we got a sealed cassette. Mad Villain demo side one. We got what else we got over here? We got a CD. Rappers coming to New Jersey and be getting fucked up. Talking about where they from and shit with them sons. They running shit and call for if you do a show in the bricks. Got, swear you was flying how we bring so much time. Wow, I love the way this box is made.
Yeah, that's a dope setup right there.
A t-shirt we're not going to open, which looks like it says, I don't know. What else we got in here?
I'll take it.
Ooh. Dope, which is, what is that?
There you go. One beer drunk version.
I give respect to all my booty niggas with the Rolex. Shining baguettes. Flashing cash and dumping my west. Especially when my
so the inside the box.
I don't hesitate. I scoop up Keith and see who's flashing at the parlay. T.O. Hide your weed, niggas, cause here I come. Looking bummy for low profile.
Like like partial shock, which is why I'm being so quiet. Just simply because, man, we love cool things like this here at the...
I just start robbing rappers in the industry. If we ain't clicking, then I'm engineering your injuries. 48 tracks of automatics and backs. Lyrically spack data to your mentality blacks. And I don't give a fuck if you did 30 kids. Still, I bring you extra.
All right, now
I mentioned earlier that we may be unboxing Fab Five Freddy's Now, if we really do have Change the Beat, it's arguably the most influential hip-hop record of all time, simply because of the sounds, and Fresh. Okay? You and in that museum where Andy was, if you want to go back to it, there's a picture of Change the Beat from the museum. And it's on the wall in the Oakland Museum of Art there. So if this really is the record, and it is, then even the Oakland Museum is aware and cognizant of its incredible value. And I'll do mine. Hold on. I'll do mine first, because that's really rare. Oh, my God. I didn't realize it was floppy. Holy shit. Okay. This is coming in from Canada. Okay. And let me just get right to it. There it is,
it.
You guys.
That is it.
There it is. Change the Beat. Fab Five Freddy, arguably the most influential hip-hop record of all time.
Okay.
There you have it. If you give me 1 second, I'm gonna play Vanna White. And so this is like this is our Redman episode, but I guess this is also like a little bit like our MF Doom episode, but a little bit also like our Fab Five Freddy episode. Ah, look at that! There it is, from the museum, and here it is on our stage. So, tell me where this is coming in from first.
So this is from the Netherlands.
This is from the Netherlands, and let me just tell you, this is one of the coolest, rarest things I think I've ever seen in my life. Look at this, you guys. You want to zoom in on the center label? Hold on, I'm going to put something white behind it. Co-starring Freddy. Blondie, co-starring Freddy, the Brattles, and Snooki Tate. And this is Yule Town Throwdown, which is like a Christmas parody of the Rapture, the Blondie Rapture song. And it's on, you know, one of these, you know, little flimsy discs that could have maybe come in a magazine or something. But man, so, you know, international sellers on eBay really suck with their shipping, because this and Change the Beat were supposed to both be with me when I went to the Kennedy Center, and they would have both been signed by Fab Five Freddy.
I remember that.
But they both didn't show up. Anything in there?
No,
nothing.
That's it.
Okay, it's all good. All right, we're getting down to the nitty gritties. We're getting down to the nitty gritties. Oh my God, this thing's gonna like blow away. I gotta.
So
record
light,
is
right.
So light. My goodness. Okay. Here we go. One last thing before we get to the biggest item of the day. Okay. And I know I don't normally get new shit. You know, the Hip Hop Museum is not meant for, like, new things. It's really meant for, you know, historic stuff. But I saw this, and I actually thought to myself, you know what? Even if this doesn't go in the museum, I'm going to wear this myself. So this is a VH1 Hip Hop Honors jacket. And the reason I like it is because suckers break like turbo and represent.
That's a nice looking jacket too.
And on the back it says this is something that's only available to folks that actually go to, you know, the award show. Okay, this isn't something you could just like buy in a store or something. So I'm excited to have that. If it doesn't go in the museum, it goes on my body. So there's something to be said there. Okay, I'm standing up. Here we go. It's happening. The moment we've all been waiting for. Jay, get the block party video queued up. The Redman block party. After I open it, going right to the block party. When Redman was hit. Well, that was, you know.
That was a little. Keep it going until it's open.
Oh my God.
We got it. Yeah.
There we have it, y'all. There we have it. Redman Gold Sales Award, RIAA, presented to his distribution company, PolyGram Distribution, to recognize the award of 500,000 sold. This album, many folks would say, revive Def Jam. Many folks would say that this album was almost single-handedly responsible for reviving, you know, the Def Jam brand.